our God, Trinity of love, and blessed is the dominion of our God, now and ever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Welcome, everyone, to our service this evening. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
We claim this time for the worship of God. May God gather us from the four corners of the earth, uniting us as one body in Christ, as we lift our voices in praise.
Into each other's hands, and like a treasure hold it, protected like a candle flame, with tenderness enfolded. Put peace into each other's hands, with loving expectation, be gentle in your words and ways, in touch with God's creation. Put peace into each other's hands, like bread we break for sharing. Look people warmly in the eye, our life is meant for strong yet loving hands, held out in trust and blessing, where words fall short, let hands speak out the heights of love expressing. Put Christ into each other's hands, he is most deepest measure. In love make peace, give peace a chance, and share it like a
Jesus Christ is the light of the world.
A light in the darkness can extinguish.
And since we live as people of the light, in faith, hope, and love, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
Join our voices with the deep groans of creation and with the cries of lament that rise from a world in travail. aching for redemption, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
With the traditional custodians of this land, the Burnerong and Wurundjeri peoples, and with all whose blood cries out from the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
Con todos aquellos que soportan las heridas de un mundo corrupto y anhelan curación y la renovación, recemos al Señor.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
With all who suffer with Christ under the weight of the sin of the world, those subjected to injustice and deprivation, those seeking refuge, freedom and peace, and especially at this time with the people of Myanmar struggling under the brutal regime, trying to reach safety and essential medical treatment in Thailand and beyond. Let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
全世界的老人、孩子和体弱的人，所有需要帮助的人， 让我们一起向神祷告。
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
With all who serve the earth and its inhabitants, with leaders, policymakers, activists, with workers, students, artists, and storytellers, and especially this week with Chris as he returns to Armidale to care for his elderly parents. Let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
With each one gathered here in prayer, with our absent sisters and brothers, with our neighbours at the Swedish Church in Turek, and with the whole of Christ Church, from the banks of the Barrow Room to the ends of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
With God's faithful servants of every time and place, all our mothers and fathers among the saints who inspire us, guide us, and encourage us, and especially this week with those whose insights helped us see new light and truth breaking forth from God's word, with Paul the Apostle, Hildegard of Bingen, Martin Luther, Teresa of Avila, John Calvin, John Smythe, Athol Gill, and René Girard, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
And with the faithful ones whose names we call on now. With these and the whole cloud of witnesses, all who have died in the hope of resurrection, let us pray to the Lord.
Into your communion, Lord, gather all creation.
Blessed are you, God of all creation, and blessed is the communion into which you gather us.
You promised through your beloved Son that when two or three gather together in his name, you will be there in the midst of them.
Send your Holy Spirit to call us by name and lead us home.
We come defeated. We come dancing. We come traumatized. We come trusting. We come aggrieved. We come adoring.
Send your Holy Spirit to call us by name and lead us home.
We come because our hearts are made restless by echoes of a song we have never heard, the memories of a place we have never seen.
Send your Holy Spirit to call us by name and lead us home.
The Lord says, if you would enter the gates of my holy city and eat from the tree of life, turn away from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. For those who sow injustice reap disaster. But the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, and peace.
O Chineke, inyocha anyị, mara otu anyị dị, ịma ihe niile gbasara anyị. Anyị ekwuputawo na anyị nọ n'ime mmehie. Jiri obi ebere gị gwa anyị.
When we use our power to dominate and our weaknesses to manipulate.
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
When we invade responsibility and fail to confront evil.
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
When we are seduced by fashionable dreams and pursue our desires at the expense of others.
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Why we not in sin if we change the world and even forget to change ourselves?
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
When we fail to integrate spirit and flesh and forfeit the wholeness you intend for us.
Lord, have mercy, Christ, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Touch your God of infinite mercy.
We renounce evil, we claim your love. We choose to be made whole.
Put an end to oppression, to contempt, and to evil talk, and God's favor will shine on you like the morning sun. Your wounds will be quickly healed. God will be with you to save you, and the Spirit's presence will protect you on every side. Sisters and brothers, your sins are forgiven.
Thanks be to God. Jubilate Deo, jubilate Deo, alleluia. Jubilate Deo, jubilate Deo, jubilate Deo, jubilate Deo, alleluia.
Let us give thanks to the Father who made us fit for the holy community of light and rescued us from darkness, bringing us into the realm of his beloved Son who redeemed us, forgiving our sins.
Glory to God in the highest and peace to God's people on earth. To God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God on earth. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, see on your people, you who are seated at God's right hand, receive our prayer. Glory to God in your heart, my God, and peace on earth. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ.
Sisters and brothers, we do not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. Therefore, let us have wisdom. Let us take heed. Let us not flee the word that comes to save.
Lord, to whom shall we go? Yours are the words of eternal life.
O Lord, your mysteries discerned in wisdom by men and women through the centuries have been etched in scarred places and recorded in holy books.
Send your Holy Spirit upon us, that your word may take root in the secret places of our hearts and may usher it to your glory.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah. Let us listen to the word of God. God has told me to shout unto you, people here, to hammer home the message until it gets through. You are God's people, but God feels betrayed by you. Listen to what God has to say about your sins. Day after day, you look good. You turn up to worship and pay attention to my teachings. You act like a people who want to do what is right, like a people who want to obey to the letter. You ask me for directions before you do anything, and you seem enthusiastic about getting closer to me. Do you want to know why your religious behavior turns me off? Do you want to know why I ignore your fasting and bowing? I'll tell you why. You put on a great performance of it all, but then you go straight back to feathering your own nest and ripping off your workers in the process. When you fast, it just makes you irritable and violent. When you behave like that, I'll just hang up on you. Do you really think this is what I'd like to see? A day of pious misery, black clothes, long faces and crocodile tears, giving up chocolate and ice cream? Do you think that's worship? Do you think that pleases me? Give me a break. Do you want to know what I'd really like to see? Dismantle the structures of injustice. Take your feet off the throats of the poor, Stop jailing the victims of unfair laws. Quit plundering nature's resources. Do you want to know what else I'd like to see? Open your tables to the hungry. Open your hearts and your homes to the refugees. Open your wardrobes to those without clothes. Don't go hiding every time you see someone in need. Do that and I'll put your name up in lights. Do that and our relationship will be healed in an instant. I'll put you under my personal protection. Anyone who attacks you will have to deal with me, the Lord. I'll be on hand to respond whenever you need me. Just say the word and I'll be there for you. If you abandon all forms of exploitation and avoid bad mouthing others to gain an edge, if you share what you have with those in need and respond to the real needs of suffering communities, then you'll find that the world will light up for you and life will be one beautiful day after another. I, the Lord, will always be there to guide you, even in the grip of death drought. I'll keep you healthy and well-fed. You'll be like an irrigated vineyard with its own deep bore, green and lush and full of life. Your ruined houses will be renovated and new. You'll be able to restore the homes that have been in your families for generations. You'll get a reputation for making dreams possible, for enabling everyone to find a good place to live. Hear the word of God.
We have heard and are silent.
For the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
Hallelujah. Happy those who love God and delight in the Lord. Their children shall be blessed, strong and upright in the land. Their households thrive, their integrity stands firm. A light shines on them in darkness, a God of mercy and justice.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
The good lend freely and deal fairly. They will never stumble. Their justice shall be remembered.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
Bad news holds no power. Strong hearts trust God. Steady and fearless, they look down on their enemy. They support the poor. Their integrity stands firm. Their strength brings them honor.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
Hatred devours the wicked. They grind their teeth. Their hopes turn to ashes.
Light rises in darkness when justice rules our lives.
reading from Paul's first letter to the Christians in Corinth. Let us listen for the word of God. Brothers and sisters in Corinth, back when I first came your way to announce the mind-boggling truth about God, I didn't dress it up in fancy words or philosophical jargon. I wanted to keep it simple and avoid getting sidetracked. So I emptied my head of everything except the news about Jesus the Messiah, and in particular, about him strung up to die. I didn't cut a very impressive figure among you, did I? A sickly little weed, scared out of my wits and shaking like a leaf. There was nothing in my conversation or my preaching that would have wowed the crowds or had anyone yelling for encores. But that didn't stop God's spirit and power showing themselves. Clearly then, your trust in Jesus was never based on any human theories, however profound, but on your first-hand experience of God's powerful work. Now, don't get me wrong, we are happy to talk about deeper stuff with those who are far enough down the track to be ready for it. But even when we do, it is not the trendy pop wisdom that is all the rage these days. Nor is it the opinions of those who call the shots on the world stage. They're on borrowed time anyway. But when it comes to speaking about God's wisdom, we are prepared to dig down and explore depths that few ever plumb. There are riches to be discovered there, which God laid down for us before the dawn of time. Clearly, none of the world's movers and shakers ever had a clue about this, because if they had, they would have known better than to knock off the Lord of glory on that cross. But as the prophets noted, way beyond what anyone has ever seen or heard or even begun to imagine lie the things which are being prepared for the people who love God. And yet God's Spirit has given us a preview of these very things. There is nothing that the Spirit hasn't thoroughly explored, not even the deepest depths of God. It is usually true that it takes one to know one. Only a human being can know what goes on in the human heart. And only the Spirit of God can truly know what goes on in the heart of God. But that is no longer the whole story for us, because instead of just being on the same wavelength as the culture around us, we have been given the Spirit that comes from God and tunes us into God, and so enables us to pick up on what these gifts God is giving us are all about. The books of philosophy and science don't even give us a language to talk about these things. We can only say anything meaningful about them if we tune into the Spirit. The Spirit transmits spiritual truth to those who are spiritually attuned. Those who are not spiritually attuned don't receive any of the gifts that God's Spirit is offering. They dismiss them as foolish and worthless. They don't recognize their depth or value, because these things can only be picked up on a spiritual wavelength. Those who are spiritually attuned pick up everything, and yet no one else can get a clear picture of who they are or what they are on about. The prophets ask the question, does anyone know what God has in mind or what God is up to? Now the answer is yes, because the Messiah has shared his mind with us. Hear the word of God.
We have heard it as silent.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us acclaim God's saving justice.
attested by the law and the prophets, and now revealed through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe.
Listen now for the gospel, hallelujah. It is God's word that changes us, hallelujah.
No eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart conceived what those who live in love and trust from God receive.
Listen now for the gospel, hallelujah. It is God's word that changes us, hallelujah.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Jesus taught his followers, saying, "This is how you lot fit into the big picture. You are the salt without which the world would quickly go putrid. But if salt is left sitting around instead of being put to use, it soon dissolves away or gets contaminated. Then what can you do with it? It is completely useless, so it just gets chucked out. Or again, you are the light without which the world would be left in the dark. Your light should be as obvious as a city built on a hill. No one turns on a lamp and then hides it under the bed. They put it out in the open, front and center, so that it can light up the whole room. That is what you should be like. Live your lives openly, reflecting God brightly, so that everyone can bask in the light of your integrity and generous love and give due credit to God who conceived you in heaven. Don't go thinking that I've given you license to start ignoring what the Bible says. I'm not getting rid of it. I'm unleashing it to do what it was always intended to do. I kid you not. Until the world as we know it comes to an end and everything is put right, the Bible will still be necessary, and not one dot of an I or cross of a T will be struck out of it. If you start thinking that some of the Bible's instructions are no big deal and start playing fast and loose with them and encouraging others to follow suit, you'll go straight to the bottom of the class in the culture of heaven. But if you take seriously what they are on about and teach others to do likewise, they'll have your name up on the honor boards in the culture of heaven. Let me give it to you straight. Don't take your cues from the experts in religious law or the devout Pharisees. Unless your integrity is way out of their league, you'll never get within cooey of the culture of heaven. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you for the gospel, hallelujah. It is God's word that changes us, hallelujah. Praise to you for the gospel, hallelujah. It is God's word that changes us, hallelujah.
Lest the word of life be lost, let us allow God to confront us in the sound of sheer silence.
Spirit of comfort and conviction, unclothe me of my pride, unweave my thoughts, uncomplicate my heart, and give me surrender, that I may welcome the deep silence which stands at the centre of my being, like the rock at the heart of our land.
Mark Twain once said that what bothered him most about the Christian message was not the things he couldn't understand, but the things he could. I suspect he was also suggesting that we often avoid the easily understandable but uncomfortably challenging parts by spending our time arguing about things that are much more difficult to understand. We heard part of Jesus' Sermon on the Mount tonight, and surely one of the reasons that the Sermon on the Mount is so often neglected in Christian teaching is that most of it is perfectly clear, but seriously challenging. Love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you. Turn the other cheek. No one needs a philosophy or theology degree to understand such things, and having a degree won't make them any easier to put into practice. Perhaps that's why it is so tempting to brush them aside as unrealistic utopian dreams of a future age and look for something more impressively complicated. When the Apostle Paul addressed himself to the people of ancient Corinth, he was speaking to one of the most intellectually sophisticated cities in the Greco-Roman world. It was a bit like how today's English-speaking world thinks of Oxford and Cambridge or Princeton and Harvard, the epicenter of higher education, culture, and philosophy. But Paul decides to address them, knowing nothing among you except Jesus the Messiah and him crucified. That is, he chose to address them with nothing more than something that he knew most of them would dismiss as crude and primitive nonsense, because he is not willing to allow the gospel to be taken as just one more complex and intriguing philosophy for detached academic discussion among the intellectuals. It's too important for that. You may remember that last week we heard him say from a few verses before these ones that God's foolishness is wiser than the wisdom of the world. So Paul is not saying that there's no wisdom here in this apparent crude simplicity. It is, he says, God's wisdom, secret and hidden, which God decreed before the ages for our glory. This wisdom of God, secret and hidden, says Paul, is not understood by any of the rulers of this age, for if they had understood it, they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. Now, I want you to note that when Paul says it's secret and hidden, he does not say that God actively and intentionally hid it. Some things can remain secret and hidden because we become blind to them, and that doesn't mean that God is at fault for hiding it from us. Elsewhere too, Paul speaks of the plan of the mystery hidden for ages in God, who created all things. That's hidden in God, not hidden by God. And Matthew's gospel says that Jesus' teaching proclaimed what had been hidden from the foundation of the world. So Paul seems to be saying that the most important mysteries of the universe were hidden from us by our own expectation that they should be too complex and sophisticated and profound for ordinary people to easily grasp. And so looking in all the wrong places, we totally missed the point. We came up with all manner of highfalutin theological theories, but really, the fundamental mysteries of the universe are nowhere near so complicated. The fundamental mysteries of the universe are simply given to us, Paul says, as gifts. God has given us Jesus as a gift. God has given us the Holy Spirit as a gift. God has given us love and mercy and hope as gifts. And all the gifts reveal the same thing, the great mystery that has been hidden by our own blindness since the foundation of the world. The great mystery that God loves us deeply and passionately and overwhelmingly. The great mystery that God really, really likes you. That God looks at you and bursts into love song, crying, "Yes, how wonderful you are. Come, dance with me, you who are beloved from the foundation of the earth." God looks at you and thinks, I love you so much, I'd willingly die for you. Oh, no, we say, it can't be that simple. That's child stuff. Surely we need a complex religious system full of sacred rituals and profound liturgies. Surely we need to know how many angels can fit on a pinhead and how many wings the seraphim have. Surely we need a religious legal code that meticulously defines the line between holiness and sinfulness and polices it fiercely. Has not the Torah given us 613 commandments and not one jot or tittle shall disappear from the law until all is accomplished? Isn't that what Jesus said? Yes, says Jesus, but all is accomplished. And all that is important in those 613 commandments, I can sum up in just two. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and soul and mind, and love your neighbor as attentively as you love yourself. That's all. If you accept the gift and know yourself deeply and truly beloved, that's all you need. What? Who's your neighbor? Well, love your enemies. That should cover it. Look, if it's still not clear, just follow me. Do as I do. Love everyone else the way I have loved you. That's all there is to it, says Jesus. Just love. They will know that you are my followers by your love. Not by your grasp of clever atonement theories, by your love. The deepest mysteries of the universe come down to one simple word that even a child can understand, love. Or rather than even a child can understand, I might perhaps say only a child can understand, because the rest of us seem pretty good at missing it and screwing it up. So good that when we saw perfect love, we crucified it. And when we realized what we'd done, we went right back to trying to turn it back into something impressively clever and complicated. We tried to fit the crucifixion itself into complicated theories of atonement and justification and divine justice. And it is possible to do that, but it nearly always misses the point, which is love, love, love. We're thinking a bit about how this relates to our children tonight, because in a few minutes we'll be celebrating the back to school blessing with them. But often we think that too much about what we are teaching them instead of asking what we might be needing to learn from them. And my comment about children often understanding the wisdom of God and the teachings of Jesus better than adults is not meant to be tongue in cheek. Yes, we are passing the faith on to them, but we need to be at least as open to receiving it from them. We heard Jesus tonight talking about us being the light of the world and letting our light shine before others. And that's certainly about recognizing the positive influence that we can have on others, young and old. And he went on in his comments about nothing disappearing from the law and the prophets to talk about what we teach others to think and do. But teaching at its best is a cycle, and we can learn a lot from listening to how our teaching and our example is received by those we're passing it on to. What do the children among us hear and understand as we try to teach them a more liberating understanding of the gospel that says that it's not all about rigid law keeping, but about getting caught up in the love and grace of God? It's quite illuminating to hear Acacia talk about this, as I'm sure a few of you have. I'm picking Acacia because she's the one young adult here who was part of this church for her entire childhood. So many of us were there through all or much of her childhood, and it was us that she was watching and listening to as she learned the faith. I hope I'm not misinterpreting her here, but I think that she would say that although she did gain a liberating and grace-filled understanding of the gospel here, we were not nearly as good at explaining it as we like to think we are. Actually, I've heard Rita say something similar. She didn't grow up among us, but her first serious encounters with Christian faith and church culture were here. So both of them were watching and listening to us. And what they both found is that most of us are a lot better at explaining what the gospel isn't than what it is. That is, we tend to try and describe it by contrasting it with something else, with the kind of faith systems that many of us grew up with, something that was more rigid and oppressive and frightening. And for those of us who grew up with that kind of thing, thinking about the contrast is a helpful way in. But it was not nearly so helpful for Acacia or Rita, because they weren't carrying the scars that we were. And so us waxing lyrical about how different it is from something they'd never even encountered didn't shed much light for them. It seems that we knew how the gospel might be good news for those who were oppressed by abusive forms of religion, but we weren't nearly so good at helping Acacia and Rita to understand how it was good news for them. Thanks be to God that it didn't all depend on us. But let it be a reminder to us to listen to these children as they grow, and don't think that the teaching and learning is all flowing one way. If we listen to what they are picking up from us, we can learn a lot about the strengths and weaknesses of our own understandings. And we can certainly learn about not trying to turn it all into something too clever and complicated, when nearly all of what really matters is just love, love, and more love. As it is written, what no eye has seen, nor ear heard, nor human heart conceived, what God has prepared for those who love him, these things God has revealed to us through the Spirit. For the Spirit searches everything, even the depths of God. And there in the depths of God, all is love. Love, freely given as a gift, fully revealed in the crucified Jesus. Love that endures everything and stops at nothing. Love so simple that many scorn it as childish and turn away. Love, the beginning and the end. Love.
We have heard the gospel proclaimed. To be able now to live it, we look to Jesus, who says, all things are possible to those who believe.
We believe, Lord. Help our unbelief.
As we declare the common faith of the church, let us sing our way onward into the life of Jesus, the life that lives and loves between the lines.
We believe in God, the Father, almighty creator of heaven and earth. We believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen, amen.
The Bible tells us that when Jesus was a child, they found him sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. So let me highlight our children. These young people are a precious gift from God and a revelation to us of the life of the kingdom. Vulnerable and easily disregarded, but restless, energetic, growing, and disconcerting. The end of the summer holidays, the summer holidays have come to an end, and a new year of school is beginning. Some of our young friends have waited eagerly for this all summer. For others, maybe it comes a little bit too soon. Some of them are brimming over with curiosity and enthusiasm. Others are wary and uncertain. Most of them are a mix of both. And all of them have a claim on our love, our support, and our prayers, both tonight and throughout the year to come. Ethan, Elijah, Tara, and Lior, you are really important to us. We love you as you are now, and we love you for all you are becoming. We care about what you are learning at school and about the friendships you form and the activities you get involved in. So I'm going to invite each of you to tell us where you are doing your schooling and what year you're in, and maybe something that you're hoping for from this year. Elijah, do you want to start and tell us where you're going to school and what year you're in?
Grade 2.
At what school?
Moreton South Primary.
Cool. And is there something you're really looking forward to this year at school?
I don't know.
Don't know? That's okay. You don't have to know. Ethan, what about you? Where are you going to school?
I go to Heathmont East Primary School.
Heathmont East Primary. And what grade are you in? What year?
Grade 2.
You're in year 2 as well? It's probably not surprising, since we have a whole bunch of children all the same age. Is there something that you're excited about with school this year?
My mum and dad are going to come down.
Ah, yeah. So you have a bit more involvement with mum and dad. Great. Now, Tara, you're doing your schooling a little bit differently. Tell us.
We school at home, and we just learn things. I just learn things as we go. If mummy just cooking, I might watch and learn something.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. And Lior, you're doing that too, yeah?
Preschool at home.
Preschool at home.
Preschool at home. Cool. And what, for you too, is there something, what's kind of your favourite stuff to learn? What about you, Tara?
I'm not sure. I'd probably cooking.
Cooking?
Probably knitting and sewing and crocheting as well.
Okay, great. And Lior, do you have a favourite thing to learn?
Soccer.
Soccer. Excellent. Very good. Elijah, Ethan, Tara and Lior, these people gathered here are the people to whom you belong, people who love you and who will watch out for you and pray for you. You're always at home among us. And we're a people who belong to Jesus and who gather under the sign of his cross. So we want to mark you with this sign so that in all that happens at school this year, you may remember Jesus' great love for you and learn to know and follow him with joy. And as we do that, we're going to sing.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Perceive the cross on your head. May you have the mind of Christ and think God's thoughts.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your eyes. May you see the world through the eyes of Jesus.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your ears. May you hear how God wants you to live.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your lips. May your words be words of love and mercy.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your shoulders.
that you may only carry what you need to carry.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your hands. May you be quick to heal yourself and others.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your feet. May you be quick to run and do what God wants.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
Receive the cross on your heart. May you love with God's heart. You love yourself and others.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God.
We offer you thanks and praise, O God of wisdom, for your gift of new beginnings and for opportunities to learn and to wonder. You are the fountain of all wisdom and learning, and you have given us the years of our youth to learn the arts and skills necessary to live honest, creative, and caring lives.
Hear our prayers for these students and their teachers, that they might win each other's trust and respect, and together make their schools places where they feel free to learn and are excited by the joy of discovery. May school and church and home together encourage them to continue to grow in wisdom and stature, and in favour with God and with people.
And now, Ethan, Elijah, Tara, and Leor, as Jesus took children in his arms and blessed them, may God hold you and go with you and bless you. May your schools be welcoming and encouraging. May your classmates be interesting, friendly, and fun. May your teachers be wise, caring, and passionate. May your lessons be creative and exciting. May your playing be lively and joyful. And may God be with you, as our prayers are with you in every hour of every day.
Amen.
And now we have some small gifts for each of you, and we hope that they are things that you enjoy learning from. They're not specifically for necessarily for school, but we hope that they will be something that is enjoyable for you to learn as you go.
Kaskana Hamilia, and the Aiba Piswasma Aja, the real Bahira Basom Inabane Sorgama Janum Bahiga, Permeshurka Putra Yeshune Hamra Man Pardan Pujari Huncha.
By God's grace, we share in Christ's priesthood, praying for the world day and night, until earth and heaven are reconciled, and all things are made right in Christ.
Let us pray for all God's people everywhere, and for ourselves in this congregation, that the Holy Spirit may continue to open our hearts and lives to the grace and truth we find in Jesus our Lord.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That we may be kept in the faith and communion of the one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That we may follow Jesus with strength and calm, trusting God's strength in our own weakness, and showing generosity and selfless care to all.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
Let us pray for the world and all people everywhere, that the world might be healed of its grievous wounds, that wars would cease, poverty, corruption, and bigotry be eradicated, and fear, disease, and despair be overcome.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That vulnerable and undeveloped nations might receive the aid and expertise they need to survive both old dangers and new, and emerge strong, healthy, and free.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and
that the powerful and corrupt would be prevented from exploiting the world's current distractions to ransack the earth and prey upon the weak and forgotten.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and
that those whose families and communities have been torn apart by acts of war, whether legal or criminal, might find justice, peace, and healing.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That our political leaders might have wisdom, courage, and compassion to see beyond mere economic management and build the infrastructure that will properly house, feed, and care for all.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That we might honour the First Nations of this land, seeking justice and reconciliation together, and taking to heart their wisdom for how to live in this land with respect and sensitivity.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers, and mercy and peace prevail.
That the most vulnerable in our society, including those without secure housing or work, those suffering illness, trauma, or disability, and those seeking asylum on our shores, might be given welcome, support, and hope.
In union with the wounded Christ, we offer our lives and prayers,
that all whom we carry in our hearts, from around our world, around our nation, and among our loved ones, might be gathered into our prayers, let us lift up to God the names of those for whom we would especially seek God's care.
Que podamos aprender a orar de la manera en que nuestro Salvador lo ha hecho, Por lo mismo, recemos como Él nos lo ha enseñado.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. On earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
We stand at the threshold of the ultimate feast, when all who hunger will be fed and the new wine of justice will be poured.
SYCBaps Christ the Promise coming to me to show the first fruits, make our belief full for the worker return.
Whosoever will may come, not because you are worthy, nor because any church gives permission, but simply because Jesus offers himself to you and you want to offer yourself in return.
Come, let us prepare the Lord's table, offering the gifts that we are and the gifts that we bring.
Béni sois-tu, Seigneur, Dieu de toute la création. Par ta bonté, nous sommes en communion les uns avec les autres et avec tous ceux qui espèrent en Jésus-Christ.
Though we are a company of strangers, in approaching this table, we bind ourselves to one another, to live in love and peace from this day forth.
Have peace with one another.
The peace of the Lord.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made.
It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. From you flows the river of the water of life, and through your goodness, we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands.
It will become for us our spiritual drink.
We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right to give you our thanks and praise, O God, for your mercy and justice are a light in our darkness, and your word our class, even heaven and earth, which you created.
Before the ages, your wisdom destined us for glory, and you have revealed your depths to us through the Spirit. When we failed in righteousness and turned our worship into a mask, hiding our oppression, contempt, and disregard of others, you rejected our fasts and prayers and sent prophets to denounce our rebellion and call us back to your way.
In your child, Jesus, and him crucified, we have seen the light of the world and found a spring of healing that never fails. You raised him from the dead and through him gave us your Spirit, who has become the rebuilding of our integrity on the ancient foundations of justice, mercy, and compassion.
So it's everything we need to share with around us, with land or water and sky.
We sing to you.
Avec les anges et les archanges qui nous enveloppent, avec tous les saints devant nous et près de nous, avec les frères et sœurs, à l'est et à l'ouest, au nord et au sud.
We sing to you.
And with our loved ones, separate from us now, who yet in this mystery are close to us.
We sing the hymn of unending grace.
Holy, 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 God of truth, God of light, heaven and earth are full of glory. Hosanna in the highest, blessed is the one who comes
We thank you for Jesus, whose life, prayer, and ministry opened our eyes to the glory of life and fueled our hunger for your long-anticipated reign of justice, mercy, and peace.
We thank you for Christ's passionate solidarity with the suffering of all the earth. For as he bore in his own body the wounds of creation, he embraced us in our brokenness and gathered us into his wholeness so that we might know ourselves beloved and serve with him as priests forever in an all-embracing Eucharist.
Blessed is our brother Jesus, bone of our bone, and flesh of our flesh, who, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and said,
"This is my body, which is for you. Do this to remember me."
In the same way, also the cup, after supper, saying,
"This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it to remember me."
Ya mere, kanyi na ta achichanke, na ngokwa ikua, anyini kuputa idi omimi ogukwa anyi.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
Therefore, here in this place, we celebrate the life that death could not hold, the life that Jesus has shared among his community through the centuries and shares with us now.
Made one with him and thus one with each other, we lay before you these gifts of bread and wine, in token of our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. For here we offer and present to you ourselves, our bodies, minds, and spirits, to be a holy and continuous sacrifice to you.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Come and brood over these bodily things, this bread and this wine. They may be for us the body and blood of Christ, healing, renewing, and making us whole.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Come and embrace us with your life-giving power, that as bread and wine are made one with us, we may become one with you, bone of your bone, flesh of your flesh.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Come and make of your gathered people the real presence of Christ for the world, living our prayer and praying our life till earth and heaven are reconciled, and all are free as Christ is free.
Glory be to you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God and Mother of all creation, as in the beginning, so now and forever.
The body of Christ given for the life of the world. Holy things for holy people.
Holy one is holy one is Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, the only one. To the glory and praise of God, to the glory and praise of God.
Let us receive what we are, let us become what we receive.
The body of Christ.
Jesus, the wellspring of life, invites all who are thirsty to come to him. So come, receive freely. Let us raise our cups as one and taste the first fruits of the coming joy. The blood of Christ keep you in eternal life until he comes.
Señor Dios, mediante el bautismo nos uniste con Cristo y nos recibiste en tu iglesia. A través del pan y el vino te ofreces a ti mismo como comida para el viaje y como gracia para el camino.
So then we go from this place as your people, following Christ in a shared life of faithful commitment to your call.
Knowing our own weakness, but trusting in the power of the Holy Spirit, let us offer up the prayer we now go to live.
God of the journey, you have called us together to walk in all your ways as a community of love and grace.
We are called into communion with God and one another.
Though now we part, gather us again into your communion to worship, work, and play.
We are called to offer ourselves to God and one another.
Employing in healing decisions, welcoming all, and shouldering my share of the load.
We are called to attend to the voice of God.
Open me to your word, in scripture, in silence, in stranger and friend.
We are called to extend God's hospitality from our table.
Fill our eating and drinking with generosity, that we may bring joy to the lonely and hungry.
We are called to nonconformity with the world's ways.
Strengthen me to face the darkness within myself and to resist all greed, violence, and desecration.
We are called to be ambassadors for Christ.
Send me into the world you love, proclaiming and sharing your mercy and peace.
We are called to nurture faith and growth.
In me and through me, nourish the seeds of grace and bring forth fruits of justice. Attune me to the voice of despair, let there be dancing to the song of hope.
We are called to live thankfully.
Cultivate in me a heart of gratitude, looking for your blessings in all things, and seeking to be a blessing to all.
This is our covenant, the prayer we would live and the life we would pray.
Yet only by your grace can we do anything, God, and you alone can hold us when we cannot hold ourselves. To you, glorious and blessed God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, be the glory and praise forever. Amen.
The Lord says, walk in my sight and behold. Make it your first work to love. My presence shall go with you, and I will give you rest. Behold, I am with you every moment, even to the end of the world.
You are the salt of the earth. You are the light of the world. Let your light shine before others, that seeing your justice, mercy, and compassion, they may give glory to God in heaven. And may God guide you continually. May Jesus Christ satisfy your needs, even in parched places. And may the Holy Spirit keep you strong and well and make your life as rich as a garden whose springs of living water never fail. Sisters and brothers, the Eucharist never ends. It must be lived. We go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ, Amen.